But come up with the evidence that's a Mr. Chairman.
The Honourable Nanaimo Hooter.
Chair, people following this debate tonight could be forgiven for thinking that this was charter schools were a result of a cup of tea politics. But we know the truth. The opposition knows the truth, which is, in fact, National had been planning well before the 2008 election to implement charter schools. 2011 election to implement charter schools. So I want to ask members on the other side of the House, why didn't they campaign on it? Why didn't they tell the public of New Zealand that they intended to implement a policy that would have fundamental implications in their communities and in the public education system? They didn't. Instead, they hid behind the cup of tea that they had with John Banks to push this particular policy through. But let's take a step back and go to the rhetoric of why charter schools were being promoted throughout New Zealand. It was there to address the long tail of underachievement and the challenging issues in Christchurch. So South Auckland and Christchurch were going to be the two areas of focus to have these particular charter schools. And then we hear from members on the other side of the House, well, don't worry, because charter schools can coexist within the current system. But there's a fundamental difference. Whereas every dollar that is spent or put into the public education system and is publicly accountable, every dollar must go towards the educational benefit of those children attending your local schools. In charter schools, not so. You can make a profit. The mates of the government can make a profit, and they don't have to be publicly accountable for the dollar they are spending within the charter school. This is a problem. They are two fundamental different ways of looking at education provision. On the one hand, our public education system, investing in our children and their future wherever they may be, so that every school throughout our New Zealand, every child can go to a good quality local school in their community. On the other hand, a pepper-potting of charter schools and cherry-picking of students to attend these charter schools, and they may or may not survive. And if we look at the research and the evidence on charter schools that has been said by many speakers before me, there is very shallow evidence to substantially prove that charter schools will make a huge difference to the learning needs of those most vulnerable in the education system. So the challenge to the government is, if they truly did believe that charter schools would improve educational achievement for those most vulnerable, for Māori and Pacifica students, why didn't they write it into the legislation? Why didn't they make it an obligation of sponsors to write into their contracts that they must demonstrate that their charter school will lift educational achievement for Māori and Pacifica students? Didn't bother. Didn't bother because they know that their rhetoric did not match up to the evidence. And this is a problem, because again we hear that charter schools will be a solution for those most vulnerable in our education system. They won't. Right now we're looking, communities are looking to nominate their boards of trustees. And one of the fundamental things we have within the public education system is parent voice within their local school to be able to help form the local charters for their local school. In charter schools, that will not be the case. You can have a board that is appointed that is not from the community, that has very little direct accountability to the parent community about how they operate and run charter schools. How can this be good when in New Zealand we have local models that show that parents do want to participate in the learning and educational targets of their children? Fundamental difference between charter and public schools. We've also heard from the minister in the seat that we need more diversity in the system. Well, how diverse do you need to be? I think New Zealand probably has one of the greatest levels of flexibility in the system. We've got integrated schools, public schools, single-sex schools, co-ed schools, kura kaupapa, whare kura, private schools. And, you know, we're a spoilt for choice The implementation of charter schools within that context serves only one purpose: suck money out of the public education system, give it to National Party mates so they can make a profit on the back of the most vulnerable learners in our society. Shame on them. Shame on them, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chairman.
I call Chris Ockenvall.
I move that the question be now put.
Sewer Williams, CO. Thank you. Order. I've given it to Sewer.